ओम नमः शिवाय स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद हिस्ट्री क्लास 11 सेक्शन 2 थीम 4 पार्ट 3 द सेंट्रल इस्लामिक लैंड। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैड अ डिस्कशन अबाउट द डेथ ऑफ द फोर्थ कैलिफ एंड द राइज ऑफ द उमायद्स। नाउ इन दिस सेशन we will have a discussion about the Umayyads and the centralization of polity, Abd al-Malik's coinage reform, the Abbasid revolution. The Umayyads and the centralization of polity. We have read in the previous session that how under the first four caliphs, the consolidation of the Islamic land have taken place. Now, in this session, in this part of the chapter, we are going to read about the further conquest of last territories and the centralization of polity under the Umayyads. Now, the conquest of the large territories destroyed the caliphate based in Medina and replaced it with the increasingly authoritarian polity. Now, the Umayyads implemented a series of political measures which consolidated their leadership within the Ummah. The first Umayyad caliph, Muawiya, moved his capital to Damascus and adopted the court ceremonies and administrative institution of the Byzantine Empire. He also introduced hereditary succession and persuaded the leading Muslims to accept his son as his heir. Now, these innovations were adopted by Caliph who followed him and allowed the Umayyads to retain power for 90 years and the Abbasid for 2 centuries. Now, the Umayyad state was now an imperial power, that is, the rule of the monarchy was set up, no longer based on directly on Islam but on statecraft and the loyalty of Syrian troops. There was Christian advisors in administration as well as Zoroastrian scribes and bureaucrats. However, the Islam continued to provide legitimacy to their rule. The Umayyads always appealed for unity and suppressed rebellions in the name of Islam. This is one of the positive side of the Umayyads. Now, they also retained their Arab social identity. During the reign of Abd al-Malik and his successors, both the Arab and Islamic identities were strongly emphasized. Now, among the measures Abd al-Malik took were the adoption of the Arabic as the language of the administration and the introduction of an Islamic coinage. The gold dinar and silver dirham that had been circulating in the caliphate were copies of Byzantine and Iranian coin, denarius and drachm, the symbols of crosses and the fire altars, and Greek and Pahlavi, the language of the Iran inscription. Now, these symbols were removed and the coins now carried Arabic inscriptions. Abd al-Malik also made a highly visible contribution to the development of an Arab Islamic identity by building the Dome of Rock in Jerusalem. Now, this is the dome which we are talking about, the Dome of the Rock, built over a rocky mount by Abd al-Malik. It's the earliest major work of the Islamic architecture, created as monument to the Muslim presence in the city of Jerusalem. Now, it acquired a mystical association connected with the night journey of the Prophet of Heaven. Abd al-Malik's coinage or reform, which we are talking about, that resembled the Byzantine coin and the Iranian inscription. Now, the three coins specimen has been shown over here. This is a transition from Byzantine to the Arab Islamic coinage. On the second coin, you can see the bearded and the long-haired caliph is dressed in traditional Arab robes and is holding a sword in his hand. It is the first extant portrait of a Muslim. Now, it is also unique because later they developed an antipathy towards the representation of living beings in art and craft. Abd al-Malik's reforms of coinage was linked with his reorganization of state finances. It proved so successful that for hundreds of years, coins were struck according to the pattern and weight of the third specimen that is provided over here. This is the third specimen. The reformed dinar was purely epigraphic. It carries the kalima. There is no God but Allah, and he has no partner, Sharik. Now, this is the first one, the Byzantine gold solidus, denarius aureus, showing the emperor Heraclius and his two sons. Now, the Abbasid revolution, for their success in centralizing the Muslim polity, the Umayyads paid a heavy price. A well-organized movement called Dawa brought down the Umayyads and replaced them with another family of the Meccan region, the Abbasids, in 750. The Abbasids portrayed the Umayyad regime as evil and promised a restoration of original Islam of the Prophet. Now, the revolution led not only to the change of the dynasty, but changes in the political structure and culture of Islam. This is very obvious to students in the history of expansion and failure of the or surrenderance of one empire to the other. Whenever a change in the ruling class takes place, what happens is the first change that is visible is in the administration and culture. Now, the Abbasid uprising broke out in the distant region of Khurasan, eastern Iran, a 20-day journey from Damascus on a fast horse. Khurasan had a mixed Arab-Iranian population, which could be mobilized by various reasons. Now, the Arab soldiers here were mostly from Iraq and resented the dominance of the Syrians. The civilian Arabs of the Khurasan disliked the Umayyad regime for having made promises of tax concessions and privileges, which were never fulfilled. As for the Iranian Muslims, Mawali, they were exposed to the scorn of the race-conscious Arabs and were eager to join any campaign to oust the Umayyads. Now, this is about the Abbasid revolution and the change of the dynasty from Umayyad to Abbasid. Now, the Abbasids, descendants of Abbas, the Prophet's uncle, mustered the support of various descendant groups and legitimized their bid for power by promising that a Masiha, Mahdi, from a family of Prophet Ahl al-Bayt, would liberate them from the oppressive Umayyad regime. Now, their army was led by an Iranian slave, Abu Muslim, who defeated the last Umayyad Caliph Marwa in the battle at the river Zab. Under Abbasid rule, Arab influence declined, while the importance of Iranian culture increased. The Abbasids established their capital at Baghdad, near the ruins of ancient Iranian metropolis, Ctesiphon. The army and the bureaucracy are reorganized on a non-tribal basis to ensure greater participation by Iraq and Khurasan. Now, the Abbasid rulers strengthened the religious status and functions of the caliphate and patronized Islamic institutions and scholars. But they were forced by the needs of the government and empire to retain the centralized nature of the state. They maintained the magnificent imperial architecture and elaborate court ceremonials of the Umayyad. The regime, which took pride in having brought down the monarchy, found itself compelled to establish it again. Now, this is about the Abbasid empire and the descendants of the Abbasid, that is Abbasid empire and the disintegration of the Umayyad empire under the succession of the Abbas, the prophet's uncle. Now, this is a great mosque. These are the changes that were brought under the Abbasid empire in Muslim domination states. Now, the great mosque of Matwakil in Samarra, the second Abbasid capital, built in 850. The minar is 50 meters high and is made of brick, inspired by the Mesopotamian architectural traditions. This was the largest mosque in the world of centuries. And the next session, theme 4, part 4, the Central Islamic Land, we will continue with the chapter. Om Namah Shivaya.